welcome. And I am not Pastor Bill. To all of you who may not have heard, Pastor Bill tested positive for COVID this week and is in quarantine per doctor's orders. But he sends his best regards and wishes to extend his heartfelt desire to be here with all of you today, and wishes everyone a blessed and happy Easter. Also not with us today is our choir director, Bob Niffin. He and his wife, Candy, also tested positive for COVID, totally not related to the same exposure as Pastor Bill, but they also wish to extend their wishes for a happy Easter and hope to be with us soon. I will add that they report they, all of them, are feeling better. We would like to extend our thanks to Scott Philly, our guest musician this morning, who will fill our sanctuary with glorious Easter music. I also want to take a moment to thank the confirmation class and their instructors and families for their presence and participation in the Maundy-Thursday service. You provided an opportunity for those in attendance to reflect on the events of the week and the Last Supper that Jesus shared with his disciples. I thank you for that time. However, Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Are there any more announcements this morning? Sue.
Good morning, everyone, and happy Easter. Our next fundraising event that's coming up is going to be on May 7th at 5 p.m. It's a meatloaf dinner. Consists of appetizer, salad, meatloaf, green beans, mashed potatoes, gravy, rolls of butter, and the dessert and beverage. Cost is $15, starts at 5 p.m., and it's also going to cake auction. So this is the time of the event that we have every year that we combine a cake auction. So that will come right after the dinner. The dinner is actually this year going to be a 50s themed dinner. So there will be 50s music playing while you are dining. And if anybody wants to pull anything out from the 50s, for those that might have some clothes or even want to go to places to pick up something to dress up, feel free to do that as well. Again, the cake auction takes place right after the dinner. It's a fabulous time. We have great cooks in this church. So I'm asking for those who could and would like to donate and make cakes for the cake auction. I would greatly appreciate it. It could be anything. A family recipe, just one of your favorites, etc. And then those will be auctioned off. We have a lot of fun with the bidding going on against everyone. Reverend Bill is the MC or the host for the evening doing that. And if you can't make the dinner but want to come to the cake auction anyways, please feel free to do so. Or if you don't bake, we'd love to have you to the cake auction as well, just to do, you know, put your bid or cash in for a cake. So again, the cakes are fabulous. A lot of the cooks in this church, so you won't be disappointed that I can come. So again, it's May 7th, and the dinner starts at 5 p.m., followed by the cake auction shortly. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sue. Before you go anywhere, I'm going to ask you to come back so you can do the lunch and reorienting.
We have come to this Sunday of profound celebration, and with it, the last phrase of the Lord's Prayer. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Where does ultimate power reside in your life? For Jesus, God was the source of power. The kingdom belonged to God, and God was due all glory and honor. When Jesus faced suffering and death, He followed God's will because he recognized God as the ultimate power in his life. Regardless of circumstances, Jesus glorified God and pointed the world to the Father. We say these words in our worship service every week, but do we truly give the power over our lives to God? Do we acknowledge God as the one in command, not only of our own lives, but of all creation? When we withhold our allegiance, when we place self or work or money in the place of ultimate power in our lives, the light of Christ is diminished. But when we bow before the Lord and acknowledge him as master of our lives, the light of Christ burns brighter in the world. Let us pray. Our Father, master of our lives, we come before you this morning with our praises, for you alone are God. You created the world and everything in it. You sustained it by the power of your Spirit. And your love provides the foundation for our relationships with you and with each other. Teach us to acknowledge your power. Help us glorify you by our good works and our faith. Let us always put you first above everything else. For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours. In the name of the risen Christ we pray. Amen.
Thank you, sir. Please join me now in the call to worship. I will be the part that says prayer, and you will respond to the part that says people. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. But God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. Let us now join in songs, hymn number 182, Christ the Lord is risen today.
Christ the Lord is risen today. Hallelujah.
grace and power, we come rejoicing in Christ's empty tomb. We come trusting in the good news that tells us Christ is with us. For the risen Christ is living proof that you care about our lives, O God. The risen Christ offers us a glimpse of hope, even in our tears, as the tomb is not quiet. It speaks, it proclaims, it is a promise of eternal life. Thank you, gracious and almighty God. Amen. Amen.
Heavy.
No one told him to do it. He did it because he loved us so much. He did it so we could have everlasting life. So, who would like to open the second? And what's in that egg? There are three nails. So, they remind us that Jesus was nailed to the cross. Can you imagine the pain that he must have suffered? And he suffered pain to pay a price for our sins. I would like to open the third.
It's a rock.
It's a rock or a stone. It's a stone. The Bible tells us that after Jesus died, he was placed in a tomb, and a large stone was placed across the entrance. On Sunday morning, two women went to the tomb. The stone had been rolled away, and the tomb was open. The stone reminds us that not even a stone, a huge stone, could keep Jesus in the tomb. So I have a fourth egg. Would you like to open a fourth egg? What's in it? Nothing. It's empty. It was empty. The Bible tells us that two women went to the tomb and they found that it was empty. Jesus was not there. At first, the women thought that the body of Jesus had been stolen, but inside the tomb, there was an angel, and he's told them, "He is not here. He is risen, just as he told you he would. See where he lay." The empty egg reminds us that the tomb is empty. Jesus is risen, just as he said he would. The Jesus we serve willingly took up his cross, but he could not be held in the cross, on the cross by nails. He could not be kept in the tomb by a large stone. He is risen and lives in heaven with God. Just like the change of the seasons from winter to spring brings new life to the world around us, the things that Jesus did bring us new life through him. Let us pray. We thank you, Father, that you loved us so much that you sent your only Son to die for our sins. We are thankful that his story does not end with the death, but that we serve a risen Savior. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now, my basket still feels a little heavy. So today, where today is all about how much Jesus loves us, I have some kisses for you. So you can get them after church, okay? Okay, parents?